shoot a shot, and that one will actually go in. That one was tipped in.
With big pile-up and a goal.
Right there.
And he puts it in. 3-2.
This broadcast of Stoughton High School boys hockey is brought to you through generous support of these WSTO supporters. Stoughton Hospital, a proud supporter of WSTO programming. Stoughton Hospital is a 2010 Wisconsin Forward Award Master recipient, providing exceptional personalized service. Trusted care close to home. The UPS store of Stoughton. You can't do it all at once, but you can do it all in one place. 2364 Jackson Street, next to Papa Murphy's. Crest Funeral and Cremation Services. Love and concern in action. The three things Crest values the most are service, service, and service. A proud supporter of WSTO programming, Radio Shack and Hanson Electronics of Stoughton, your local U.S. Cellular and Dish Network authorized dealer, Pizza Pit of Stoughton, a proud supporter of WSTO programming, and the official pizza of WSTO's staff.
Welcome to the Mant Center for high school boys hockey on WSTO-TV. It's great to have you with us for this Badger South Conference matchup between the Monona Grove Silver Eagles and the Stoughton Vikings. James Weingard with you from the Mant Center in Stoughton tonight on a Saturday. Hope you're having a terrific weekend. And we welcome you inside to what is now a dark Mant Center as the players get ready to come out onto the ice. Silver Eagles come into the matchup. They are 3-3-0 in the Badger South Conference. 3-12-0 overall. And the Vikings are 1-4-0 in the conference, and they are 3-11-1 overall. The Silver Eagles are coming in off of a win against Milton on Friday night last week, so 8 days ago, and that was a 6-0 win. They lost to Middleton by a score of 5-2. They beat Monroe 4-0, lost to Oregon 7-2, and they lost to Madison Edgewood by a score of 5-1. Meanwhile, the Vikings in their last few games have had a tough go of it. They lost to the McFarland Spartans 10-0 a week ago. They lost to Oregon 4-1, lost to Edgewood 9-3, lost to Janesville 7-0, and lost to Milton 3-2. And that is a check on previous games. The Silver Eagles come in with a offensive scoring output of 2.13 goals per game. They give up 4.07. And the Vikings come in scoring 2.07 goals per game, and they give up 4.80. We will get our starting lineups here for you in just a second, and then we will have the opening faceoff after the national anthem.
Athletes, coaches, or team representatives will not be tolerated in our grounds for removal from the site of competition.
You're looking at a dark screen as they have a spotlight on the Viking goalie. It'll be Carson Roysom in goal tonight.
Features the visiting Monona Grove Silver Eagles against our Stoughton Vikings.
And we'll start with the Silver Eagles starting lineup.
The Monona Grove Silver Eagles starting in goal, number 31, Drew Gilbertson. At defense, number 18, Alex Baldwin. Also at defense, number 21, Brett Zach. At forward, number 9, Riley Seifert. Also forward, number 12, Wyatt Knipper. And forward, number 20, Tanner Smith. Followed by the rest of the Silver Eagles team. The Monona Grove Silver Eagles are coached by David Kinsler and assisted by Craig Dobinspeck, Joe Schuart, Toby Kinsler, Sean Blinn, and Chris Bradford. And now for your Stoughton Vikings. Starting in goal, number 35, Carson Royson. At defense, number 7, Jack Sanford. Also at defense, number 10, Sam Wallin. At wing, number 9, Jeffrey Houston. Also at wing, number 13, Austin Seeley. And at center, number 11, Justin Gibbons. Followed by the rest of the Vikings team. The Stoughton Vikings are coached by Chris Washelt and assisted by Brett Crawley and Matt Lennon. The officials for tonight's contest are Chip Taggart, Bert Beecher, and John Perkins. Now I ask that you please rise, remove your hats, and honor the flag with the playing of our national anthem.
There's our national anthem, and we are all set and ready to go for high school boys hockey here tonight from the Mant Center in Stoughton. Reminder for you that you can follow us online, WSTO.tv, and on social media, facebook.com/WSTOTV. And you can also find us on Twitter at WSTOTV. Coming up, we've got the Tom Hartman program, weekdays at 1 on WSTO. Tom's one of America's leading voices in progressive talk. And then that's the Tom Hartman program at 1 o'clock, and that's followed by Democracy Now!, which is an independent look at the news that shapes our world. That's at 2 o'clock weekday afternoons. And, of course, start your weekend off with Saturday morning cartoons every Saturday from 8 until noon on WSTO. Plus, Screen Time. They review popular new releases and hidden gems. It's Tom Richardson's Screen Times. And for that, check your local listings on schedule.wsto.tv. So the Silver Eagles, 3 wins on the season. All 3 wins have come against conference opponents, Milton, Monroe, and Stoughton. The first time these two teams met earlier in the season, the Silver Eagles won by a score of 5-1. That was back on Saturday, December 10th. And we are underway, and this is hung up at the red line, kicked into the zone by Justin Gibbons, and a shot hits the outside of the post right off the bat. Andrew Gilbertson is the goalie tonight for the Silver Eagles. They'll play it up the far side wall, and that'll go to Wyatt Kniffer, held in by the Vikings. They play it back behind the net. A couple of players wrestle for it there. Now a centering pass right in the middle, shot save made off the stick of Justin Gibbons, and the puck goes behind the Silver Eagle net. They hang it up in the corner over here on this side. Gibbons comes over to help out, picks it up behind the net, and to the corner. Drop it back down. Silver Eagles there to intercept that pass. Brett Zapp. And now the Silver Eagles will start a rush. Wyatt Kniffer has it. Long bounding puck goes in on Roysom. And he'll put a glove on it and cover it up. 16:04 to go in the opening period. Just underway. from the Mant Center in Stoughton. Carson Roysom in goal tonight for the Vikings. 0-7-1 record, 4.72 goals against average, 89.8% save percentage. Off the faceoff, it will be down to the corner and hacked at by Zeth Zeichert as it heads over to the far side and then back behind the Vikings net. First to play it there will be Keaton Gill for the Silver Eagles. Gill has it back in the circle. Zeichert wiped him out. Coming up on a minute and a half gone here in the period. Here's a shot and a redirect from between the circles. Nice job there. Jack LeMeyer got a stick on it right between the circles and it goes over the glove side shoulder of Roysom and the Silver Eagles have a 1-0 lead. So 1-0 Silver Eagles, minute and 26 into the contest. Keaton Gill and Sam Smith with the assists off the Jack LeMeyer goal for the Silver Eagles. Face-off in the Silver Eagles zone, 15:24 to play in the opening period. Again, the Silver Eagles won the first matchup between these two teams back in December, 5-1. Centering pass gets knocked away. Sam Wallin had it for the Vikings. Can't clear the zone, though. He'll get it back down toward the corner and then taken away from him by Tanner Smith. Puck goes sliding through the slot over to the near side on the wall. And out to neutral. Silver Eagles send it right back in. Wallin has it in front of his own net. Wallin trying to get it out of the zone and a giveaway into the circle. Backhand shot. Save made by Roysom. Sweeps it back toward the wall. They'll play it back to the near side. Centering pass. It hit Roysom in the side twice. And now they get it back in front again. And Roysom snares it out of the air with a sweeping motion of his glove. And he'll keep the score 1-0. 14:38 to play in the first. Face off in the Viking zone. Off the face off, it heads down to the corner and sent for a ride around the backside of the net. Zeichert pops it along and this will be right at the blue line, held in and off the rebound, the turnaround shot, they were gonna try and get the shot away. Tanner Smith at the bottom of the circle, but he overskated it. The puck came back out and it was just out of his reach. 14:24 left in the first. Face off again in the Viking zone. Both players will get tossed out of the face off. This will be hung up in the circle. They play it off to the near side wall, poked out to neutral ice, collected there by Garrett Vinci, and now back into the Viking zone. They'll send it back to neutral and delayed offside. Puck goes right in on Roysom, now to the near side of the net. Zeichert trying to get it out of the zone, finally does, and this will be touched by Garrett Vinci as he'll track it down back in the corner. Under 14 minutes to play. Puck came back out in front, and the Silver Eagles will pop it back out to neutral. Zeichert with it. Played off the glass, settled down for a moment by Brody Lavacek. Silver Eagles will send it into the zone, collected by the Vikings, and they'll start the rush up the near side. Chad Clark trying to get around traffic, and it's settled down by Lavacek, and he gets dislodged from it. Now pushing ahead is Ryan Berger, shot and right into the glove of Roysom again. Another faceoff coming here with 13:28 to play. Faceoff drawn into the corner this time. And they'll wrap it around to the far side of the ice where Austin Sealing waits for it. Five players battle for it. Puck came free and Sealing has it back. He'll play it off the boards, back out to neutral. Silver Eagles send it right back in. Sam Wallin will go and chase it down behind his own net. 13:05 to play in the first period. Poked ahead, out to neutral, and the Silver Eagles will turn and fire it right back into the Viking zone. Over to the corner on the other side now. Wyatt Knipfer has it, trying to feed it down to the corner. Vikings clear it out, and it is batted into the zone by Jeffrey Houston and down to the corner. Puck slides behind the Silver Eagle net, and it's popped in the air. Sealing battling with Brett Zapp down there in the corner. Taken away by Justin Gibbons, centering pass, and that's blocked back out toward the corner. They play it high off the glass, comes back out to neutral ice now. Justin Gibbons comes from behind, gets a takeaway, and back out to neutral. And now the Silver Eagles will have an opportunity here as they get bumped into the corner. 12:15 to play. Puck right behind the net, trying to stuff it in at the side. Penalty coming up. It's going to be a Viking penalty to the circle in this near side. Kick save made. Loose puck in the crease. And the Vikings touch up, and we're going to get a charging call against the Vikings. So Sam Wallin goes off for charging, as you see him sitting down in the penalty box for the time being. 11:59 to go in the first period. Silver Eagles on a power play, and that shot is swept aside by Roysom. Comes back out to the blue line, now into the circle, moving in right in the middle, shot, save, rebound is loose at the top of the crease, and the Vikings able to clear it out. Sam Smith sends it back into the Viking zone, and Zeichert bounds it off of the official's knee, and then it was Quinn Link coming over to clean up the mess as it's sent into the Silver Eagle zone. 1:26 left in the penalty, 11:25 left in the first period. Starting the rush right down the middle, Keaton Gill trying to pick his way through a double team. Link has it back. He'll just take a whack at it and send it all the way back down to the Silver Eagle zone. Gilbertson comes out of goal to play it. He'll set up behind the net. Now start the rush up the far side. Moving ahead is Wyatt Knipfer. Knipfer trying to get around Justin Gibbons. Behind the net. Comes out to this near side. Knipfer still with it. At the high slot now. Lost a handle on it. Picks it back up and drops it down to the corner. Back out to the point now for Garrett Vinge. And now Riley Seifert. This side. Shot. Save made by Roysom. Had a good look at it. Shot taken by Tanner Smith. And Royce makes the save. 45 seconds to go in the penalty. 10:45 to go, first period. Silver Eagles power play this year, 10.7% success rate. And the Vikings penalty kill, 74.3%. 40 seconds to go in the penalty. Vinge with it, high slot. That's blocked down by Justin Gibbons' stick. And a blast redirected off of a stick at the bottom of the circle, and Royson able to cover up the slow-moving puck. 33 seconds to go in the penalty. Faceoff drawn down to the corner this time. Dane Sutton, among others, back there battling for it behind the net. Now they'll emerge out to the top of the slot, to the circle now here on this side. Turnaround shot, hit a knee and another shot. Save made from the stomach of Roysom. And behind the net, we're down to 15 seconds to play in the penalty. Knipfer tracks it down in the corner. They'll send it out to the point and out of the zone. That should have been offside, yeah. So the puck came just above the blue line. A little bit of a delayed call, but they got it right. And there's 4 seconds left in the man advantage for the Silver Eagles. 10:04 to go in the first period. Faceoff coming just outside the Viking zone. And this will be controlled by the Silver Eagles. And the penalty is over. Both teams back to full strength now. As Jack Sanford has it for the Vikings. They'll throw it over here to this near side. Centering pass now between the circles. A shot, kick save made by Roysom, and he'll not give up a rebound as he covers it up and then scoops the puck into his glove with his stick. 9:49 to go in the first. Faceoff hung up in the circle, and the shot taken, save made by Roysom. Out to Lavacek now, and then poked out by Quinn Link as he gets smashed into the wall. And back into the Viking zone. They'll send it down wide of Roysom. Lavacek has it in the circle now for the Vikings. Bump from behind as Zeth Zeichert got taken down. Vikings will be able to clear. Now they've got a 2-on-1, 3-on-1 developing. Link with it to the circle. Centering pass went behind everybody. Silver Eagles cleared back out the other way, and now they've got a 2-on-2 break. And this will be carried in by Gill. He lost the handle on it. Loose puck in the top of the crease. Now Zeichert has it, and he'll carry it back behind the net. Approaching 9 minutes left here in the first period. Silver Eagles with the steal back deep in the Viking zone, and they'll pop it up off the back of the net down to the corner. 8:55 to go in the period. And a centering pass, and that shot goes high and wide off the stick of Riley Seifert. Back out, and this will be icing, but it'll go right in on Gilbertson. He puts the stick down and blocks it back all the way down to the other end, icing this time against Monona Grove, and a faceoff coming in their zone with 8:38 to play. Opening period, 1-0, Silver Eagles with the lead. Faceoff in the Monona Grove zone after the icing call. And off the faceoff, this will be taken by the Silver Eagles out of the zone. Justin Gibbons has it, turns the corner, eludes one, top of the circle, shot got blocked down, and they'll settle it down in the circle here on this side. Coming back now is Ryan Berger. Berger trying to pick his way through a triple team. Silver Eagles finally get a handle on it. They send it in toward Royce, and he puts the glove on it, and another faceoff coming here with 8:20 to play. Vikings' next game will be at Baraboo Portage, and then our next home game with the Vikings will be their home finale. That'll be on January 31st, so next Saturday, and that'll be against Madison Edgewood. 8:18 to play in the opening period. Puck went. 31st is indeed a Tuesday. I'm thinking today is the 24th, but that's not right. Today is the 21st. Saturday the 21st. So 24th is Tuesday. A week from Tuesday will be the next home game for the Vikings. 8:14 to play. Faceoff back in the Viking zone again. They'll wrap it around the boards to the other side. This is going to slide all the way down. They wave icing off this time. Chasing it down, Brett Zapp. He'll catch up to it finally behind his own net. Send it back to the corner on the other side as Austin Sealing goes over and throws a hip check into Matt Prebush. No, it wasn't either. It was Garrett Vinci over there, number 5. And now the puck out to neutral, over to this near side. And this is going to be Tanner Smith with it down to the corner. He'll get around traffic. He's trying to stuff it in on the side, taken away by the Vikings. Now 2-on-2 back the other way. Nice move. Oh, and a trip. Down goes Justin Gibbons. Penalty coming up here against the Silver Eagles. Sealing has it. Now that Gibbons has it back. And a shot, kick save made. Another blast from the circle, and that goes wide of the mark. Gibbons has it, it isn't either. It's Zeichert, now down to the corner. Sam Wallin with it, around the backside of the net, over to this near side. And now finally the Silver Eagles touch up, and we will get a penalty against the Silver Eagles for a trip. Riley Seifert heads off for tripping. And he goes into the Monona Grove penalty box. 7:15 left in the first period. Here's Zeichert over to this side for Gibbons. And that goes right through the slot. Rebound comes to Zeichert at the bottom of the circle. Carries it into the corner and then behind the net. Emerges over here, centering pass. He'll bounce it off the wall over on the far side now. Quinn Link with it, and moving in, shot. That redirects, and then I think it may have hit, clipped the top of the crossbar. Back out to the top of the slide. Here's a blast again. That hits a shin, and the rebound comes back, and now the Silver Eagles shorthanded come back. Keaton Gill with it. Top of the circle, shot. Roysom, save, and covers it up. 6:37 to play in the opening period, 1:22 to go in the Viking power play. Vikings on the power play this year, 13.5% success rate. Penalty kill for the Silver Eagles, 79.2%. 1:22 to play in the first. Justin Gibbons has it for the Vikings as he's, no, it's not either. It's Zeth Zeichert behind the net. And now he'll start the rush up the near side with Quinn Link. Lavacek, and a near giveaway, now it will be. Brett Zapp has it shorthanded. A couple of players tumble over one another. Zapp got it upended. Vikings lost an edge, and they give it away in the circle. And a shot, never got in on goal. Gibbons almost gave it away, and now Wallin has it. And this is batted out of the air. Sent back into the Vikings zone. 48, 47, 46 seconds left in the penalty. 6 minutes to go in the first period. Moving ahead now, it was Gibbons as he gets whacked into the Monona Grove bench. Bump behind the net, and they'll play it out to the point. Glove down there by Zeichert. A couple of players waited for it, and they gave the Vikings give it away. Here's a shot coming in on Roysom. Lets it go through his glove and into the corner. First to play it there is Ethan Ebert. 16 seconds left in the penalty. That bounces off of a Silver Eagle stick, so they wave icing off. First to play it down there is going to be Dawson Dutcher, and it comes back out to neutral. Settled down there by Ebert. Played off the glass back into the zone, and the penalty is done. 5:15 to go in the first. 1-0 Silver Eagles, and they will fire it out to neutral. Settled down there by Keaton Gill. Gill 1-on-3, and a shot never got in on goal. It was blocked down. Puck ricochets off a couple of bodies. Settled down now by Jeffrey Houston. It comes out to neutralize. Chad Clark with it, and that's going to be offside as Austin Sealing was astride into the zone before the puck was. 4:55 remaining in the first. Jared Bauer and Sam Smith take the faceoff this time. Bauer sends it into the zone. Silver Eagles tip it back out. It gets dumped in the corner. Puck slides behind the net. Wallin first to play it. And he'll send it up around the bend to this near side wall. 4:40 to go in the first. Silver Eagles have a 1-0 lead. Puck loose out at the point. Now settle down. Shot never got through. Second one does and goes top shelf. And the Silver Eagles have a 2-0 lead. So 12:30 time of the goal this time. Keaton Gill with the goal. And with 4.5 minutes left in the first, it's now 2-0 Silver Eagles. Played off the boards. Alex Baldwin and Sam Smith get the assists on that Keaton Gill goal. 4:10 to play in the first period. And Chad Clark goes and hammers one of the Silver Eagle players into the boards. Back outside the zone, that's going to be offside. And a trip as well. So Brett Zapp heads into the box for tripping. So the Vikings on a power play again. 4:02 to go in the first. Vikings now trail by 2. Puck comes out to the point where Justin Gibbons has it. He'll drop it over here to Lavacek, top of the circle. And now Gibbons, Rister, save made. And this is going to be fired out of the zone right in on Roysom as it spins. Puts the stick down and gives it to Justin Gibbons. 1:40 to go in the penalty. Gibbons up the far side wall. Nice move there. And Justin into the zone to the circle. Another nice move and he scores! Couple of really nifty moves that time by Justin Gibbons. First all the way back in the defensive zone to throw it off the wall, got it back to himself, put a nice move on at the circle, and then was able to beat Gilbertson, and a power play goal for the Vikings trims the lead to 2-1.
11 non-assisted.
So Justin Gibbons gives the Vikings their first goal tonight. It's now 2-1 off the power play goal. 3.5 minutes left here in the first period. And Sam Wallin has it in the corner for the Vikings. Take away by Keaton Gill. Tried to center it. Vikings got in the way of the pass. Down to 3:11 to play in the period. Austin Sealing waits for it over on the far side at the circle. Wallin whiffed on the pass. Comes back out to the point. Settled down there. They move toward the middle in a redirect. And Roysom covers it up. And then a bump from behind dislodges the net from its spot. Clock stopped with 3 minutes to go. Three minutes even to play here in the first. Faceoff coming in the Viking zone. Net's been reset, and the faceoff was hung up in the circle, and that bounces off the side of the net. I think Carson may have gotten a little piece of it. And they trying to bound it in front. Backhand shot, save made, and Roysom able to cover it up. Ethan Ebert got knocked down. 2:49 to play here in the first period. Face off again coming in the Viking zone. Silver Eagles win it. Shot, save made. They try and chip it away. Loose puck. And the Silver Eagles pick the loose puck up as Roysom couldn't find a handle on it. And it's going to be Tanner Smith. No, it isn't either. It's going to be Wyatt Knipfer. 12 got the goal. 20, Knipfer gets the assist. 14:16 time of the goal. And that'll make it 3-1. Jeffrey Houston with it for the Vikings. And a whistle stops play as the net came off of its spot again. Looked like maybe Ryan Berger got bumped into it. Face off outside the Viking zone. 2.5 minutes to go, 2:31 to be exact, here in the first period. Face off goes all the way back into the Silver Eagle zone. Zap with it, sends it across to the middle now for Brady Gerenthonis, and he'll send it in. Sam Wallin plays it from behind his own net. Wallin had it come up into his body, finally settles it down. Wallin off to his right, down to the corner now, carried it all the way down, finds or tried to get it to Gibbons on a little drop pass. And now Berger has it for the Silver Eagles. Long pass ahead over to this side, and that's going to be a knockdown. Poked ahead there by Houston as he gets wiped out. Touched in by the Silver Eagles. 1:45 to play in the first period. Moving in toward the side of the net. Big pileup, backhand shot, save made by Roysom. Lavacek with it on the far side. Oh, nifty move there to get around traffic. Here's a 3-on-3 now, and Lavacek still with it. Here's a blast from Quinn Link on a drop pass, and Gilbertson makes the save. 1:27 to go. Face off in the Monona Grove zone. Four goals here in the first period, three on the Silver Eagle side and one for the Vikings. Faceoff drawn down toward the corner, and first to play it is going to be Wyatt Knipfer. They'll send it behind the net, and now the Silver Eagles will start the rush up this near side. Now they tip it toward the middle, sent back to Seifert. Played high off the glass, knocked down out of the air by Lavacek, not out of the zone though. Lavacek has it back for the Vikings. And Seifert coming up on a minute to play here in the period. Lavacek does get it out, and this will be offside as it went right back into the zone. Seifert was in the zone when he touched the puck. 59 seconds left in the first. Justin Gibbons uses his body to block players away from it. Gibbons right down the middle. Backhand shot high and wide to the right. Rebound comes out to Ceiling over at the far side at the circle. 43 seconds to play here in the first. To the blue line, held in by the Vikings. Top of the circle again. Now it comes out, and this will be icing. Probably wave this off. They do. 32, 31, 30 seconds left in the first. Silver Eagles have it behind the net. And a giveaway, and this is flipped up off the glass. And they'll send it right back in, but we've got an offside call. 20 seconds to go in the period. Faceoff is going to come right at the center circle. 20 seconds to play in the first period. Quinn Link and Brady Geranthonis will take the faceoff for their respective teams. Quinn sends it into the Silver Eagle zone. 15 seconds to go in the period. And a giveaway to Bauer. Couldn't hold on to it, though. Now back the other way comes Keaton Gill. Play gets hung up over here at neutral ice in front of the penalty boxes. Vikings turn, send it across to the other side. They'll get one more shot away, but that goes well wide to the right. And we have reached the end of the first period. Our score, Monona Grove 3, Stoughton 1. This is High School Boys Hockey, the Badger South Conference on WSTO TV. Welcome back to the Mann Center. James Weingard with you on WSTO TV. It is 3-1. The Monona Grove Silver Eagles lead over the Stoughton Vikings at the first intermission. And taking a look at our scoring summary from the first period, it was Jack Lemire scoring at 1:26 to give the Silver Eagles a 1-0 lead. And then 12 and a half minutes, it was Keaton Gill with the second Silver Eagle goal. And then a minute, a little less than a minute later, Justin Gibbons got on the board with a power play goal to make it 2-1. And then Wyatt Knipfer, about 50 seconds after Justin scored, made it 3-1. And that's where we stand at the moment. And taking a look at our Stoughton Hospital stats report through the first period, it was 15 shots for the Silver Eagles, 7 for the Vikings, 12 saves for Carson Roysom, and 6 saves for Drew Gilbertson. 2 penalties, 4 minutes for the Silver Eagles, 1 penalty for 2 minutes for the Vikings. And that's a look at our Stoughton Hospital stats report as we get ready for the second period here tonight. And a reminder for you that we have girls hockey for you coming up on Tuesday, which is the 24th. That would not be today. And then we have girls hockey again on the 27th. And then we'll wrap up our hockey coverage on the 31st of January. And yes, as a reminder, next year we will be in high definition here along WSTO. So hope you look forward to that as much as we do. And we will get ready for the second period here tonight with the Vikings trailing by a score of 3-1. Chris Rosholt, the head coach for the Vikings, and coaches for Monona Grove, David Kinsler, Craig Dobinspeck, Sean Glynn, Chris Bradford, and Toby Kinsler. Face-off for the second period, off we go. And it will be Alex Baldwin sending it ahead to neutral ice. And this is gonna be Tanner Smith moving around traffic. Sam Wallin pokes it back out to the point. Here's a wrister, and that goes whistling through the slot all the way back out to the near side. Top of the circle now, shot. Glove saved down by Roysom, and a nice job there. And the face-off coming. We are 20 seconds deep into the second period. Faceoff held into the Viking zone and around the bend. It'll be held in on the far side by Brett Zapp. He'll drop it down to Quinn Link at the corner, and then he carries it behind the net. Give away to the Silver Eagles. Ebert smashes in one of the Silver Eagle players behind the net. That pass a little too far in front of Chad Clark, and this will be icing against the Vikings. Faceoff coming back down to their zone with 16:15 to play in the second. Vikings on the road for their next three games. They're at Baraboo Portage on Tuesday. They'll be at Monroe on Friday the 27th, and then at Whitefish Bay on the 28th, home against Edgewood, and then we've got a game against Milton on Monday, February 6th, at Beaver Dam on February 7th, and they wrap things up at Oregon on February 10th. Puck comes out to neutral. Big collision over on the far side. Penalty coming up. Somebody barking at somebody else down there. And actually, I think it's just going to be icing. We are just now at a minute gone here in the second. Face off in the Silver Eagle zone after the icing call. And this pops out to neutral. Sent back into the zone. Vikings clear. Silver Eagles send it back down to the other end. Justin Gibbons has it now across the blue line. Justin picks his way through traffic. That pass ended up going behind Jeffrey Houston. And now the Silver Eagles send it back again toward the Viking zone. Gibbons had it for a second. Kicked into the zone now and be chased down by Ethan Ebert in the corner. Ebert carries it behind the net, over to the circle on this near side. They try and get it toward the middle, and it ricochets to Zeth Zeichert. That takes that odd hop off the Zamboni door that we've seen so many times over the years, out to the point. That hits bodies in front, now chipped along, and out of the zone. Zeichert trying to give chase, catches up to it, and turnaround shot, save, and Austin Sealing had a look at it, and the puck ends up over in the corner. 15:06 to go in the second. Another shot, kick save made, shot taken by Zeichert. They'll try and get it back to the point. Gibbons couldn't catch up to it. And now it'll be into the Viking zone and Ryan Berger. Berger behind the net. He's being chased by Zeichert. Three players battle for it behind the Viking net. Finally, Silver Eagles trying to stuff it in on the side a couple of times, and Royceham able to make the save both times. 14:41 to play in the second period. 3-1 our score. Both teams full substitutions. Jeffrey Houston a little slow to get off the ice. Looked like he had a bit of a limp, a bit of a hitch in his giddy up there as he was heading back toward the toward his bench. Hopefully nothing too strong there or too severe. 14:41 to go in the second. Out to the blue line, and that's batted over to the corner. They wrap it around the boards to the Vikings. Out to Lavacek, and it gets popped up high in the air. Quinn Link settles it down. Vikings clear it back out to neutral. They look up, delayed offside. Now everybody's ready. Sam Wallin has it for the Vikings, and he'll start up the far side. Met one of the Silver Eagle players. That was Tanner Smith. Lavacek with it, bottom of the circle. Sends it across to the other side now. Chad Clark has it, and he'll send it out to neutral. Lavacek had it go behind him, picks it back up, and then gets muscled over toward the wall. 3 minutes gone in the second. Puck still in the Silver Eagle zone. And they clear it out up to this near side. Wyatt Knipfer starts up to the circle. And a centering pass. Royceham able to make the save somehow. Now this goes behind Chad Clark, and icing will be called here against the Vikings as the puck wobbles across the Silver Eagle goal line. 13:39 to play. Looked like maybe it was Sam Wallin that gave his body up as he was sliding through trying to prevent the pass, and a couple of players were able to keep the puck out of the Viking goal. 13:39 left here in the second. Justin Gibbons with it for the Vikings, using the linesman as a pick. Now a two-on-two. Gibbons still with it to the circle. Moves toward the middle. Tried to get it to Sealing. He finally did get a handle on it, but didn't get a shot away. Down to the corner. 13:20 to play in the period. Right to the side of the net. Gilbertson looking for a handle on it. Looks behind him. Puck hung up along the boards. Now the Silver Eagles come away with it, and they'll start the rush up the middle. Sam Smith pushing it ahead into the zone to Keaton Gill. Centering pass that almost was an own goal. Zeth Zeichert at the last second able to keep it out. Now Justin Gibbons starts up this near side, and he'll head to the left. Here's a trying to get around traffic, but a good job defensively by Brett Zapp. Back to the other end now. Keaton Gill with it again. Here's a wrister and a blast, and Carson Roysom snatches it out of the air, and we've got a faceoff coming in the Viking zone with 12:40 to play. Zeichert giving his goalie a good job, pat on the helmet. 12:40 to play in the second. Here's a shot top of the circle. Kick save made by Roysom. They'll throw it over to the wall on this near side. Now Lavacek has it. Long pass intended for Quinn Link. That got intercepted by the Silver Eagles. Now carried back in by Monona Grove into the circle. Back centering pass went behind Matt Priebusch. Ends up in the corner. They bump around over there. Wallin has it behind the net, trying to jam it in on this near side. Roysom keeps his pad tight to the post, and they will bound it out to neutral ice now. Coming up on 12 minutes left here in the second. Lavacek with the steal. Here's a shot. Save made by Gilbertson, and he'll hold on. ...12 minutes to play in the second. Faceoff coming in the Silver Eagle zone, and Monona Grove will start the rush over to the far side. Little out of the reach of Tanner Smith. He's got it back, though, down to the corner. Centering pass. Roysom makes a couple of nice saves again, and he'll hold on, and we'll get another faceoff here. We're down to 11:50 to play in the second. Jack Lemire, Keaton Gill, Wyatt Knipfer scoring for the Silver Eagles in the first period. Justin Gibbons with a power play goal. Vikings not able to get it out of the zone. They'll have to retreat back to the corner. Jack Sanford still with it back there. Then finally taken away from him by Tanner Smith. Centering pass hit bodies, and it ended up careening into the corner. And now Wallin will start the rush up the far side. Finally taken off of his stick. He's got it back, though, into the zone. Taken off of his stick again. Now settled down, or trying to get it, was Austin Sealing. Now the Silver Eagles start the rush. Gibbons battles for it at the red line. They'll go back to Sanford again in the corner, and they'll try this side this time. And that went behind Sealing. Shot goes well wide to the left. Sanford plays it back to Zeth Zeichert. He'll wrap it around to into the corner. And then a nice move there by Justin Gibbons with help down the middle. Gibbons moving in from the circle with a shot. Save, rebound, another save. And the Silver Eagles clear it back out to neutral. Ethan Ebert ahead. Lavacek had it bounce around off of his ankle. Turns the corner, enters the zone. Gets around traffic down to the corner. 10.5 minutes to play in the second. Shot hit the side of the net. Monona Grove clears it. Knipfer right at the blue line. Taken down by Chad Clark. And he plays it off the boards. This will go into the Silver Eagle zone. Gilbertson comes out of goal to play it. Back out to the top of the circle. Give way to Lavacek. And now the puck slides down to the corner. First to play it there, Brett Zapp. They'll try this side. 10 minutes to go in the second. Out to neutral ice now and pushed ahead. Moving ahead is Keaton Gill into the circle here on this side. And in the circle, shot last minute redirected by Zeth Zeichert. Well wide, not a harm's way. Now behind the net, they're going to have help coming down the middle, but they couldn't get it to him. And a pass goes across to Lavacek, back to neutral ice with Quinn Link down the middle. Lavacek chasing it down to the corner and right in front. And that shot goes high and wide to the right. 9.5 minutes to play in the second. Puck still in the corner, back out to the point now. Zeichert holds his own. They'll drop it down toward the circle now. And back out to the point. Quinn Link has it. That bounced off of a knee, and then it'll go out of play. 9:14 to go. Second period, 3-1 our score. Silver Eagles in front. Faceoff coming in the Viking in the Silver Eagle zone. Faceoff drawn down toward the corner, and Minnegona Grove has it with Alex Baldwin. And back out to the point, Justin Gibbons has it now, and he'll throw it down to the corner. First to play it there, Brett Zapp, give away behind the net, over to the side of the net, now back to the corner along the near side wall. He'll send it behind the net again. Now it finally does come out of the zone. Vikings turn, send it right back to neutral and then in to the Silver Eagle zone. Gibbons will be first to play it. Has Lavacek in the middle. Justin gets bumped out of the play. Puck pops up in the air, now to the circle, comes out to the point, held in, now cleared out by Monona Grove. Gibbons has it back, poked off of his stick by Gerenthanas, and a shot, and that will go sailing out of the rink over the glass. Off of Carson Roysom's stick. Faceoff coming in the Viking zone now with 8:18 to play. There you see him picking up the loose puck that just got airmailed out of play. Our camera guy Noah down there has been target practice on a few shots this year as the puck has gone sailing over the glass down in that corner where he's normally stationed. Out to the blue line and out of the zone. Dawson Dutcher sends it back in. Coming up on 8 minutes left here in the first period. Gloved down by the Silver Eagles. This will be sent right back in. Zeth Zeichert first to play it for the Vikings. Played off the boards and a little back pass goes out of the zone. They'll send it right back in, though. And now this time it's going to be Ethan Ebert. They'll try this side. And it is going to be sent all the way down. Icing will be called against the Vikings. And a faceoff coming back to the Stoughton zone with 7:41 to play. We've got Noah, Spencer, and Ben on cameras tonight. And Derek producing and directing out in the truck as always, or as usual, I should say. Here's Brody Lavacek with a head of steam into the zone, shot, save made chest high, and Andrew Gilbertson makes the save, 7:33 to play. Face off in the Silver Eagle zone this time. And this will be heading down to the corner. Chad Clark plays it for the Vikings off the backside of the net, trying to get it back in front. They couldn't. And now over to the far side, Quinn Link down to the corner. Zapp sends it to the corner on this side, and Zapp will get it back over on the other side. Now they'll start the rush, and touched into the zone by Lemire, and icing is going to be called against the Silver Eagles as the pass went in from just behind the red line. 7:10 to go. We saw four goals in the first, three on one side, one on the other, and we've seen nothing yet here in the second. Granted, we had almost 11 minutes worth of gameplay that elapsed between the first two goals in that first period. 7 minutes to play here in the second. Silver Eagles in front, 3-1. Mentioned it a couple of times as a puck comes in front, and Gilbertson makes another save. That the first matchup between these two back in December went the Silver Eagles' way by a score of 5-1. Silver Eagles had scored first in that first game. Vikings tied it up, and then the Silver Eagles scored the last four. And in this one, the Monona Grove scored the first two. Vikings got one, and then the Silver Eagles got another one. Back in the MG zone, played off the wall in front of the Viking bench. Vikings settle it down in the corner, and they'll send it around to the other side where Jeffrey Houston will go over and try and pick it free. Gibbons sends it out to Zeth Zeichert at the point, settles it down on the forehand side, takes the shot, and Gilbertson makes the stomach save. 6:25 to go in the second. Faceoff coming again in the Monona Grove zone. And this one sent down to the corner where it's played by Dawson Dutcher. Now four players try and dislodge it from the wall over there. Gibbons knocks it down out of the air from the blue line. Shot, kick save made by Gilbertson, and he'll send it back into the corner again. Now behind the net, Garrett Vinge into the circle. Turnaround shot, that ricochets through bodies, and Austin Sealing will chase it down here in the corner on this side and then send it back behind the net. Houston to Gibbons. Then Sealing comes over and knocks down one of the Silver Eagle players. Gibbons sends it back toward the middle. Glove down by the Silver Eagles now. They've got a 4-on-3. Here's a pass going right to the middle, but couldn't quite get it to Wyatt Knipfer as they play it off the near side wall. Knipfer has it now as he will send one toward the middle, and a goal off the centering pass to Tanner Smith. So Tanner Smith with the goal for the Silver Eagles. It's now 4-1, and Wyatt Knipfer gets the assist. 5:28 to play in the second. Offside the call there.
Tanner Smith with assist from number 12, Wyatt Knipfer.
Face off outside of the MG zone. Carried in by Lavacek. Puck goes right along the blue line. Lavacek has it back. They'll send it back to their own zone. Dane Sutton across to Sam Wallin. Long pass ahead, trying to get it to Chad Clark. This should have been offside or very close to it. Coming back is Keaton Gill. Gill settles it down. His shot goes high and wide to the right. Under 5 minutes to play now here in the second as the Silver Eagles will try and dump it in the corner. They'll play it back. Chad Clark with it now as he fires it off the boards. They'll send it back in, delayed offside. Sutton has it back now for the Vikings. He'll carry it behind his own net and right down the middle. Push it ahead to Chad Clark. He couldn't control it. Back out to neutral. Sutton fires it back into the Monona Grove zone. Brett Zapp into the Viking zone. Sutton with a swing and a miss. Down to the corner now. Prebush with it for the Silver Eagles. Comes out to the point. Held in there. Now Quinn Link behind the net. Wallin sends it for a ride down to the Monona Grove zone. And it's going to be icing. 4:04 to go. Faceoff hung up in the circle. They kick and they slash and they hack at it. Finally comes free and played off the wall. Simon Shelley sends it down to the Silver Eagle zone and another icing call against the Vikings. Faceoff coming back to the Stoughton zone with 3:53 to play. Faceoff this time won by the Silver Eagles. Shot save made by Roysom is popped in the air and then dropped right into his glove. So we've got another faceoff coming. Shot off the faceoff, save made by Roysom. It'll drop down to the corner for Ryan Berger. Back behind the net, comes in front, and they'll dump it over to the corner. 3:38 to play in the second period. Vikings trailing 4-1. And a centering pass, and Roysom makes a blocker pad save made. Off to the corner now. You hear him bump into the wall over there. Back behind the net, here's Justin Gibbons. Gibbons kicks it back to himself. Gets around traffic, shot, and it's a goal. I thought he'd made this. I thought Gilbertson had made the save, but apparently it hit the underside of the top of the net. So the Vikings get a goal back. It's now 4-2. So Justin Gibbons, his second goal tonight, unassisted. And it's now 4-2 Vikings. There's a look at the replay as it went right over Gilbertson's shoulder and hit the top of the net. And so the Vikings now trailing 4-2. 3:06 left here in the second period. Wyatt Knipfer in the corner. He gets knocked down, gets back up, plays the puck. Out to the point. Played there by Brett Zapp. Zapp with a shot. Now we're going to get coincidental minors here, it looks like, as a couple of players were wrestling with each other behind the play. So we've got Wyatt Knipfer going in for Monona Grove with a cross check, and Chad Clark in for the Vikings with a slash. So we stay 5-on-5. Clock runs with 2:47, 46, and 45 to play in the second period. Lavacek with it for the Vikings. And gets hacked off of his stick. Dane Sutton trying to clear the zone. Does not. Now right down the middle. Backhand shot. Never got in on goal. Wallin got in the way of the pass, or the shot. Chipped along and out of the, not quite out of the zone. 2:22 to play in the second period. Centering pass, net went all the way back out to the blue line. They'll throw it back down to the corner. Quinn Link plays it for the Vikings. Back behind the net, and a centering pass. Kicked aside by Roysom into the corner. Tanner Smith tries to send it out toward the middle. Here's a shot, and that never got through. It hit Wallin in the backside. Turnaround shot, Roysom makes a save again as it drifts into the corner. Lavacek, little back pass, trying to get it out, could not. Lavacek's got it back, kicks it toward the blue line, wobbles there right on the blue line. Now they finally do get it out of the zone. The Silver Eagles send it right back in. Dane Sutton will go and pick it up in the corner for the Vikings. He wrestles with Sam Smith, and now the Vikings just send it all the way down to the other end, and this will be icing against Stoughton. And probably more so to get a line change here than anything. 1:28 to play in the second. 4-2 our score. Faceoff coming in the Stoughton zone. They play it off the glass, right back in. Ceiling lets it go by. Zeichert overplayed it at the Zamboni door. Down he goes. They emerge from the on the far side of the net, and now taken away by Justin Gibbons. 1:11 to go in the second. Gibbons picks his way through the Monona defense, all the way down to the corner, still with it, Justin. And emerges on this side to the corner. Now back into the corner on the other side. Less than a minute to play in the second. That hit his stick and ends up ricocheting all the way into the corner. went high in the air. Now long pass ahead up this near side. Moving ahead is Vinji, and he lost the handle on it. Austin Sealing sends it back out toward the blue line, and it does come out of the zone. Keaton Gill sends it back into the Viking zone. Ethan Ebert up the far side of the ice. 26 seconds to play. His shot gets knocked down by his shin. And then it tracks into the corner. Back behind the net now. 18, 17, 16 seconds to go. And a near giveaway. Now it is. Vikings turnaround shot. Save made by Gilbertson. Comes out to the point. Wallin has it with 9 seconds. And that one goes just wide to the right. 5 seconds to go in the period. And they'll just pin it up along the wall. Down to 2-1 centering pass, and then it's steered aside as the horn goes. We have reached the end of the second period. One goal on either side. We'll recap that and the second period stats when we come back. This is High School Boys Hockey, the Badger South Conference, on WSTO-TV with the Monona Grove Silver Eagles leading the Vikings 4-2. Welcome back to the Mann Center. James Weingard with you on WSTO-TV. And it is 4-2. The Silver Eagles of Monona Grove lead over the Stoughton Vikings. In that second period, it was Tanner Smith with a goal at 11:30 to give the Silver Eagles a 4-1 lead. And then Justin Gibbons got his second goal of the game at 13:46. And that puts us at our current score of 4-2. And taking a look at our Stoughton Hospital stats report, 31 shots on goal now for Monona Grove, 16 for the Vikings, 14 saves for Gilbertson, the goalie for the Silver Eagles, and 27 saves for Carson Roysom. 3 penalties, 6 minutes for Monona Grove, and 2 penalties for 4 minutes for the Vikings. That's our Stoughton Hospital stats report as we get ready for period number 3. Vikings are grouped at the top of their staircase over in the corner over there. And looks like Monona Grove will be coming out of their locker room here in just a second as well. Reminder for you that Tom Hartman comes up at 1 o'clock weekday afternoons with the Tom Hartman program. And that's right here on WSTO-TV. And that's followed by Democracy Now! Weekdays at 2, and then of course you can start off your weekends on the right foot with some Saturday morning cartoons. That's Saturday mornings from 8 until noon on WSTO. And then Tom Richardson's Screen Time, one of our newer programs, and that has movie reviews of popular new releases and hidden gems. And you can find out when you can find Screen Time on schedule.wsto.tv. So the Vikings come down the stairs, the Silver Eagles, you see them in the upper corner of the screen getting ready to come out onto the ice for this third period. Again, a reminder for you, we've got but 3 more hockey games left on our broadcast schedule this year. The Icebergs, the girls, will be playing on Tuesday, which is the 24th. And then the girls will be in action then again on the 27th, which is Friday. And then the boys will be in action a week from Tuesday, which is the 31st. And that'll be against Madison Edgewood. And that'll wrap up our coverage of hockey on this 2016-2017 season. And of course, we will see you next year in high definition. All right, we begin the third period now. Vikings trailing by a score of 4-2. And off the opening faceoff, Brett Zapp with it. He'll send it into the Viking zone down to the corner, and Sam Wallin not quite catch up to it. Justin Gibbons has it, plays it over to the wall on the far side, catches up to it now, across the blue line with a shot, and that goes off the shoulder of Gilbertson. Into the middle, now they'll dump it down to the corner. Austin Sealing will have a whack at it. A couple other players, 4 players battle for it. Now the Silver Eagles will start the rush, and here is Wyatt Knipfer. Over to this side. That went behind and underneath the stick of Tanner Smith. And the puck comes out to neutral. Sam Wallin with it for the Vikings. He'll turn the corner and get bumped at the neutral zone. Down to the corner. Wallin first to play it for the Vikings. Down he went. Puck still hung up behind the net. And this is out of the reach of Chad Clark. Vikings cleared it all the way back down to their own zone. A little over a minute gone here in the third. Back out to the point. That hit the linesman skate. Hung up at the blue line. Puck goes bounding in at the zone. Out to neutral and then down to the Silver Eagle zone. Wave icing off this time. Wrap it around to the far side. Jack Lemire give away to Lavacek, and that gets redirected into the glass behind the net. Into the circle, and the Silver Eagles not able to clear the zone. Batted out of the air by Lavacek. Into the circle, shot, and the save made by Gilbertson. Then Garrett Vinge tripped over him while he's laying down covering the puck. 15:08 to play in the third. Face-off in the Monona Grove zone. This one heads over to the near side, and it'll be Brett Zapp playing it behind the net. Over to the far side, and Vikings able to hold the zone. They'll dump it down to the corner as we take under 15 minutes to play in the third period. Back down to Austin Sealing. Now Justin Gibbons heading toward the middle, but he got dislodged from the puck. Comes back out to Justin out here at the point. Slaloms his way through a couple of different players. Centering pass, knocked aside. Little back pass from Houston. Goes to the corner on the other side. Now this Monona Grove will get it back out to neutral. Sealing comes up from behind, takes it away. Zeth Zeichert gets it back to Sealing and out toward the blue line and out of the zone. 14-14 to go in the third. Ethan Ebert pushes it ahead to the corner. Down goes Wyatt Knipfer. Centering pass goes through the slot. Nobody there, though. And the Vikings play it off the boards. Back to the point, held in. And that shot goes just wide to the left. Over to the other side. Another big collision over there. Knipfer and Ethan Ebert get tangled up. Quinn Link gets it back. Link up the far side will clear the zone. Link into the offensive zone. That shot goes right across the top of the crease. Chad Clark comes crashing in, trying to get a hold of it. Couldn't. Knipfer sends it in toward goal. Wallin up to the blue line, held in. That shot never got through. Here's a dangerous look as that one gets saved by Roysom, kicked into the corner. Silver Eagles again out to the high slot now, collected by Lavacek, and then over in front of the Viking bench, back to the blue line, not out though. Zeth Zeichert now will start the rush for the Vikings across the blue line with help in the middle. And a shot, and a score! Zeth Zeichert gives the Vikings another goal. It's now 4-3 with 12:48 to play. Chad Clark will get the assist on the Zeichert goal. Vikings have clawed their way back in to get within a goal now. Still great plenty of time, 12 and a half minutes to play. Out to neutral ice, sent back in off of one of the Vikings skates. Sam Wallin swings and misses on the pass. It'll be Priebusch with it. And now Wallin has it again behind the net. Wallin to the middle. Pass went behind Jeffrey Houston. Comes all the way back down now toward the blue line. And it's going to be Vinci. Vinci parallel to the blue line, sends it into the Viking zone. Dane Sutton first to play it for the Vikings behind his own net. Poked away from him right in front of Carson Royson, who collapses on it. And we'll get a faceoff coming here with 11:58 to play in the third period. Faceoff in the Viking zone. And this heads toward the middle. Now the Vikings will start a rush. Ethan Ebert with it across the blue line, down to the corner. Centering pass right in front. They shoot, and it's still loose. Into the circle now. Link has it, lost it, picked over to the near side wall. Chad Clark comes down to help out. 11 and a half minutes to play in the third, and it'll go to the far side circle, checked down toward the corner. Lavacek trying to get around traffic. Lavacek's got it back, comes, Link wasn't ready for the pass, and the puck goes sliding all the way down to the Viking end. 11-15, 14 and 13 to play in the third period. Pass goes into the zone off of Chad Clark's stick. First to play it, though, is going to be Alex Baldwin down to the corner. Shot taken from the top of the circle, or centering pass anyway, as it came out in front. They'll chip it out to neutral ice, collected there by Zeichert, who just scored for the Vikings. Ebert plays it off the boards. Link lets it go by, and it's collected by Baldwin again for the Silver Eagles. Baldwin has it back in the middle. 10:46 to play in the game. Chipped along now into the zone. And a shot. Blocker pad save made by Royson. Puck loose in the corner. Link will collect it for the Vikings. 10:33 to go. Out to neutral. That pass went behind Clark. And first to play it, Garrett Vinci for Monona Grove. To the far side now. It will go to Zapp. Out to neutral. Vikings send it right back in. That was Zeichert sending it in. Loose puck over here on this near side. Justin Gibbons comes over to assist as they pin it up along the boards. And now popped up high in the air, and puck spins its way down to the other end. 10:05 to play, and this is icing against Monona Grove, and a faceoff coming back down to MG's zone with 10 minutes and 4 seconds left in regulation. Vikings trail 4-3. They have been down by as much as 4-1, but now two goals by the Vikings. Justin Gibbons at the late stages of the second. Zeph Zeichert here in the third have gotten the Vikings back within one. Moving ahead now, Keaton Gill for the Silver Eagles. And the Vikings send it around to the other side, out of the zone. It's going to be tipped, so no icing here. We're under 10 minutes to play in the third period. Vinci with it. Now Gibbons steals it away from him. Top of the circle. Silver Eagles trying to get it out of the zone. They do. Back to the Viking blue line, and they'll send it over to the near side wall. Keaton Gill gets bumped into the boards. Sam Wallin plays it for the Vikings. Back behind the net. And it, on this side, Jack Sanford has it. Now to the middle. Quinn Link trying to get it out of the zone. Ceiling comes over to help. It will get back to neutral. They'll send it right back in, but that bounces off of Quinn Link's arm or hand or glove or something as he kind of shook his hand out a little bit. Sanford with it now for the Vikings. Back out to neutral, sent ahead by Link, and that pass knocked aside by a stick. Prebush with it for Monona Grove, right in on Royson's glove. He will hang on to it, and we have 8:57 to play in the third period. .857 to go, third period. Vikings trailing 4-3. Puck hung up in the circle. Still loose. And the Vikings will get it back to the blue line and clear it out. Quickly back the other way now. Zeichert, who scored the last Viking goal, into the circle. Center is one, and that goes underneath Gilbertson's pad, and he'll hold on. 8:40 to go. Faceoff coming in the Monona Grove zone with 8:40 to play here in the third. Faceoff won by the Silver Eagles. Out to the blue line. They whiffed on the pass. They'll send it toward the middle now. Straka with a shot. That never got through. Backhand shot hit the side of the net. Royson came way out of his goal. Out to the point now. Here's a shot. That one never got through. The loose puck ends up in the corner and then out of play as it is lifted over the glass. 8:22 to go. Remaining. Face off in the Viking zone. This one heads down to the corner. And right in front. Shot goes wide to the right. 8:15 to play. Down to the corner again. Vikings try and get it out of harm's way. Justin Gibbons collects it behind the net. Starts the rush up the far side. Austin Sealing has it. Sealing getting whacked at by Sam Smith. Into the Silver Eagle zone now. Sealing puts it on the backside of the net. There's a loose stick. That was Sealing's stick. And now it's a one-on-two back the other way with Keaton Gill. Gill down to the corner. Got it back. Centering pass hits bodies and caroms off to the side of the net for a second time. Lemire behind the net. Now Gibbons with it. 7:33 to play in the game. Up the near side wall. Justin Gibbons into the zone. Tracks it down in the corner, behind the net. He's one on two, essentially. Justin still with it, collects it all the way back out to neutral ice, resets the offense, and promptly gives it away. 7:13 to play. Ryan Berger came back. Now we've got a whistle-stopping play, and it's going to be an interference call. Penalty coming up here. 7:09 to go. Dane Sutton heading into the box for the Vikings for an interference call. So Vikings looking to try and get an equalizing goal. Now have to fend off a two-minute power play with 7:09 to go in the game. Into the circle, out to the point now. Sam Smith with it, to the circle on this side. Back across, centering pass, turnaround shot. Save made, loose puck. And now Royson has it. We've got pushing and shoving after the fact. Referees come in, separate everybody. 1:48 to play in the power play. 6:56 left in the third period. Face off on the other circle this time. And this one gets jammed into the wall. Out toward the blue line. And that one gets redirected in front of Royson over to the corner. Centering pass, and the Vikings flip it high in the air and out of the zone. Minute 35 left in the penalty. Lavacek trying to get back one back shorthanded. And now back on the other end, it's Dawson Dutcher right in toward goal, and Royson sticks his glove out, and it falls harmlessly into it. 1:26 to play in the penalty. 6:34 remaining in the third period. Faceoff this time drawn down toward the corner, and Sam Wallin sends it out for a ride to Riley Seifert at the point. Seifert's got it back in the circle, moving in, and that pass goes behind the net. 1:14, 13, and 12 to go in the penalty. 6:20 left in the game. Out to the point, and the slot, and over to the circle. That pass went behind Seifert. Down to the corner, behind the net, sharp angled shot, another save made by Royson. Kept it out a couple of times. They'll go back to the other side now into the circle. Less than a minute to go in the penalty. Another shot. That's kicked out to the corner. Penalty, not a penalty. The net came off of its spot. There's an awful lot of bodies moving around. A lot of moving parts in that blue paint right in front of the Viking goal. 51 seconds left in the penalty. 5:59 to play in the game. Faceoff heads down to the corner. And now collected by Wyatt Knipfer at the top of the circle, out to the blue line. Back to the circle now on the far side. That will be to Seifert. Vinji, this side shot. That one goes through the crease and actually ends up going out of play. 35 seconds remaining in the man advantage for the Silver Eagles. Faceoff is going to come outside of the Viking zone, so they get a bit of a break there. Carried in by the Silver Eagles, in between the circles, shot, and Royson with another save right in the midsection. Down to 29 seconds left in the penalty. 5:38 to go in the game. Face off again in the Viking zone, back out to the point. Seifert, now Vinci with it. Into the corner, nobody was there. They'll play it back behind the net. They'll feed it over to the corner again. 18, shot, and Royson makes a save, sticks it back to the wall, right in front, swing and a miss on the shot. Out to Vinci at the high slot, 10 seconds to go in the penalty. Over to the circle. Back to Vinci again at the high slot, to the circle on this side. That shot got blocked out of harm's way. Now the race is on, back to the other end. Zeichert with it, into the circle, centering pass, and that skipped underneath Quinn Link's stick. Oh boy, golden opportunity. Back out to Ebert, just inside the blue line, held it in. Just under 5 minutes to play in the third. Vikings down by one. And this is back out to the neutral zone. Power play is done, both teams are at full strength. Alex Baldwin has it for the Silver Eagles. Plays it far in front of everybody. Icing against Monona Grove. And a faceoff in the Silver Eagle zone with 4:38 to play. Remaining. Vikings need one to tie. Off the faceoff, Vikings have it out to the point. Wallin with a drive, and Sealing pushes it along. Justin Gibbons with it, turnaround shot, save made, loose puck in the crease, and now covered up by Gilbertson. 4:26 to go. To play in the third. Face off won by the Vikings. That is Jeffrey Houston bounding it off of an ankle, and it goes into the corner. Silver Eagles are going to start a rush up this near side, and it's going to be to Keaton Gill. Gill gets around Dane Sutton, down to the corner, 4:12 to play. And in front, right between the circles. That bounced off Sam Wallin's shoulder and settles down at the side of the net. They'll try and clear, they will. Justin Gibbons has it, 3-on-2 now. Gibbons around traffic, into the middle. His shot goes wide to the right. Centering pass right in front, and it hits the side of the net. 3:53 to go in the game. Houston, not able to hold his own. Comes back to Sam Wallin at his own blue line. Back into the middle now. And at the red line, it is Brett Zapp. He'll send it in. No icing here. Puck slides behind the net. Wallin whacks it out toward the blue line. Here's a shot. Save made by Royson. Sticks it over to the corner. 3.5 minutes to play in the third. Back into the corner once again. Four players battle for it. They pin it up along the boards. Finally squirted free. And now a big pile up over at the side of the net. Vikings come away with the loose puck. Jeffrey Houston trying to get around traffic, lost control of it down to the corner. We come up on 3 minutes remaining. Back out to the far side, lost an edge, puck came out of the zone. They hammer it back in, right in on goal, and Gilbertson sticks it over here to this near side wall. Now Baldwin with it. Alex Baldwin across the red line, sends it in, right into the stomach of Carson Royson. He makes a save, and we get a stoppage of play with 2:50 to play in the third. Face-off coming in the Viking zone, and whistle stops play, and we're going to get another face-off. The outside official out here just above the blue line is going to toss Riley Seifert out of the face-off. 2:49 left, puck in the circle, and still loose. Now the Vikings come away with it. Jack Sanford with it. Sanford into the zone. 2:40, 39 and 38 to play in regulation. Near side, Quinn Link into the corner. Link will come over and battle for it. Boy, relentless as he shoots up along the far side wall. And this is going to be a giveaway. Here comes Tanner Smith. Smith, with help, crashes into the net. Taken down from behind. I think the referees are going to have to talk about this. I don't think the puck went in before the players did. Three players crashed into Roysom. And we're going to get a penalty on the Vikings. Zeth Zeichert's going to go off for holding. So here's a look at it on the replay. We'll see a couple of players crash into Roysom. Oh, yeah, the puck definitely was in before the net came off of its spot. That's for sure. Boy, what a good look at it there. And Vikings may have dodged one as they are down a player. Centering pass, that shot goes just wide, and now the net came off of its spot. Yeah, what a tremendous look at the puck, definitely getting into the goal before the players crashed into Roysom. Out to the top of the circle, and that shot blocked down. 1:46 to go in the penalty. The difference between the penalty clock and the game clock is about 12 seconds, so the Vikings will be down a player almost for the rest of the game. Back out to the circle. And out to the high slot now. Sam Smith with it. Over to the other side. And a shot. Save made by Roysom, and it goes out of play. 1:29 left in the Viking penalty. 1:42 to go in the game. Off the faceoff, this is going to head down toward the back wall. 1:24 to go in the penalty. Silver Eagles leading by one. Back to the corner now. Near giveaway. Referee got in the way of it. Over to the near side circle. Sharp angled shot. Save made. Loose puck. Put back off the top of the bar. It's still loose. And now it finally does go in. After a big pile up, Silver Eagles able to get it up and over a big mass of humanity who had crashed in front of Roysom. And it's now 5-3. Wyatt Knipfer gets the goal. So 5-3, that's a power play goal too, by the way. Vikings, I think, have called timeout here. Maybe not. Referee was over talking to the Viking bench. They're going to talk a little bit further about this. All three officials you see there talking at the red line. There's 1:18 left in the third period. And apparently the referees have come to an agreement that it is a good goal. I think maybe they were talking about whether or not Roysom had ever really covered it up, or they were chipping away at it and trying to get it out from under his body. But the one official is down there talking with the Viking bench. And he's explained it enough where Rosholt has said, Coach Rosholt has said, okay, I guess we'll go with that. So, 5-3. Vikings get it out of the zone. Coming up on a minute to play. Puck goes behind the net, now right at the side of the net. Tried to get it in front, and now covered up. Now we've got pushing and shoving after the whistle. Gilbertson making the save. Sticks are up. People talking things over. A couple of teammates are pulling Sam Wallin out of the pile. Alex Baldwin goes into the box for unsportsmanlike conduct. So the Vikings are going to be on a power play for the rest of the game. Barring a goal, of course. So here's where we're at. We have 57 seconds remaining. Vikings are down by 2, 5-3. They will have a power play. One referee and the linesman talking to the assistant captain for the Silver Eagles, that's Sam Smith. The other official is over here right in front of the MG bench talking with their coach. Meanwhile, the Vikings over on the other side are trying to figure out how to get two goals in the next 57 seconds to send this one to play some more. All right, fine, I'll say it. Vikings need two goals to send it to overtime. Oh. See, we have a tradition among our crew here on our hockey staff that anybody that ever says the O word, overtime, always gets their shins kicked after the game because we never want to see overtime. But in this case, we'll make an exception. Because if the Vikings can somehow come away with an overtime session, trailing 5-3 with less than a minute to go, we would definitely have seen something at that point. So, Vikings have an empty net down to our right. They'll have 6 attackers against 4 defenders for Monona Grove. And less than a minute to go, Vikings need 2. Back out to Justin Gibbons, winds up blast, and that shot goes just to the wide to the right. Now Lavacek with it. Lavacek centers one, got it loose to Quinn Link, over to the corner here on this near side. They'll clear it back out to the point. Justin Gibbons has it, 42, 41, 40 seconds. They'll clear it out, and this is going to go well wide of the mark. 35, 34, 33 seconds. Gibbons has it for the Vikings. He'll start the rush, 30 seconds to play. And a giveaway, and the Silver Eagles score an empty netter. It will be Brett Zapp taking it away from Justin Gibbons, and it's 6-3. So Brett Zapp gets the 6th goal for the Silver Eagles. Justin Gibbons has it for the Vikings. Backhand shot goes wide. 17, 16, 15 seconds to play. Gibbons back again. That drive goes high and wide to the right. Under 10 to go. Out to the top of the circle. They play it back off the boards. Down to 1 second. Dane Sutton sends it in, and the Silver Eagles hold on to win this one by a score of 6-3. In that third period, it was Seth Zeichert getting the first goal of the period for the Vikings, only goal for the Vikings, to make it 4-3. And then at 15:42, Wyatt Knipp for a power play goal to make it 5-3. And then Brett Zapp, an empty netter at 16:35 for a little more insurance. And that's the way this one comes to an end. Again, our final score tonight, it's the Silver Eagles 6 and the Vikings 3. So our updated standings now, conference standings for the Silver Eagles, they're now 4-3-0, all four wins coming by way of Stoughton, Milton, and Monroe, 4-12-0 overall. Vikings drop to 1-5-0 in the conference and 3-12-1 overall. Our next hockey game will come your way on Tuesday with the girls. It'll be the Icebergs on Tuesday the 24th. The next boys game, they'll be on the road at Baraboo Portage next week. And then home finale will be our next boys hockey game on TV, and that'll be on January 31st against Edgewood. So again, our final score here tonight, it is the Silver Eagles beating the Vikings by a score of 6-3. Thanks, as always, to our crew, Ben and Noah and Spencer on cameras, and Derek producing and directing out in the truck. And we will see you Tuesday for girls hockey. Till then, James Weingart from the Mann Center. This has been a presentation of WSTO Sports in association with Stoughton High School. For more, go online, WSTO.tv. We'll see you next week for more hockey. Till then, good night from Stoughton.
And that one will actually go in. Initially, actually, that one was actually tipped in.
Big pile up and a goal.
Right there.
And he puts it in. 3-2.
Yep. This broadcast of Stoughton High School Boys Hockey is brought to you through generous support of these WSTO supporters. Stoughton Hospital, a proud supporter of WSTO programming. Stoughton Hospital is a 2010 Wisconsin Forward Award Master recipient, providing exceptional personalized service. Trusted care close to home. The UPS store of Stoughton. You can't do it all at once, but you can do it all in one place. 2364 Jackson Street, next to Papa Murphy's. Crest Funeral and Cremation Services, love and concern in action. The three things Crest values the most are service, service, and service. A proud supporter of WSTO programming, Radio Shack and Hanson Electronics of Stoughton, your local U.S. Cellular and Dish Network authorized dealer. Pizza Pit of Stoughton, a proud supporter of WSTO programming and the official pizza of WSTO's staff.